From that side, taken in by Hill. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. They give him a gain of 37.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Now the first carry here for Todd Gurley. Touchdown, LA! Todd Gurley, 31 yards. And the Rams are going to take a first quarter lead. Nice run by him, don't get me wrong, but the blocking up front was a thing of beauty.
I think for an opening drive, how about that for an exclamation point? Just what you said, good blocking, good vision, and he accelerated to the end zone.
Robbie Gould on for the extra point. Trick shot on the extra point, but it is good off the left upright, and it's now a 7-0 game. So a 75-yard scoring drive on just three plays, and it's finished off by a Todd Gurley touchdown run. Gould now out to kick it away. Here's the dangerous Tyreek Hill. Take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. So here come the Browns for their first drive on offense. And a look here at their go-to guy under center.
It's pretty much become the norm when we see guys come out before a game and go through the route tree with their receivers. I thought it was exciting for us to see the exact same thing happen in practice.
He's so meticulous, isn't he?
He really is, and it's not just a one-time-a-week thing. They work on it all the time, trying to hone that fine edge. They want to see if they can get in sync and stay in sync in this one.
Here on this first play as he gets it to the line of scrimmage and no more. Ray Lewis up from his linebacker spot to make the play. So nothing there. I don't know if that's all in the back, though. You got to look at blocking there, don't you?
I would agree with that totally. At some point, they have to win at the point of attack. Instead, it was the defense getting it done again and holding them to no gain.
On second down, here's Barkley. And this may be a carbon copy as he'll again be stopped right at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down. They had a great read there from his free safety position. And Charles, you know with those guys, it's all about their eyes. They have to be laser focused.
Yeah, I had to fake my way through it when I was playing, but now I can see exactly what they're doing. And on that play, he obviously had no presence to feel like he's being pushed for a pass. And without that, that allowed him to get up to the line of scrimmage and hold him to no gain.
It's been a fun ball here. They get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A good play there as the Browns strike for 16 on the first down.
I know at the end of games, coaches always tell us that no one play won or lost a game. This seems pretty important early, doesn't it? Their ability to pick up that first down on third down, I thought that was key.
Well, you're already in the hole after the touchdown on the other side. How do you respond? We talk about that a lot. And they responded pretty well there. You go three and out, I think you give up a lot of momentum. You get down two scores, could be an entirely different game.
So they've got a nice drive going now. They're in good shape. What's interesting to me is they're also in that spot in the field where you would take a shot. Do you change that up just because you're down a touchdown?
To throw on second, McMahon. And that's caught by Rice. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. A nice gain of 21 yards.
The goal for for any offense versus his own defense. Find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. And before they can run another play, the clock hits triple zeros. And time is up on the first quarter. 7-0 is our score. We'll be back with more of Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports.
The NFL on EA Sports is fueled by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
Back with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gaughton. The Browns with a football to begin quarter number two. And they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Angeles. They'll be looking to duplicate that first drive, the one that got them that 7-0 lead.
Of course they would. Look, they're on the road. So getting the 7-0 lead was huge for them, right? Imagine getting up 2 touchdowns on the road, taking the crowd out of the game. It'd be ideal.
So good field position for the Rams as they come up first and 10.
Change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. Gets to the 10. A nice gain of 21 yards.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
Little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report, but business to take care of before we get there.
A 2-minute drill before the coaches. 2-minute drill.
This will be the first red zone opportunity now for the Rams. It's first and 10 from the 12. The intended receiver, and it's second down.
I like the play call. Roll him out. Give him a chance to run it or throw it. In this situation, he decided to fling it, but couldn't find his man open.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Go, go. the backup now, the former Badger, Melvin Gordon. And he'll be taken down here at about the 11. Only a yard of the pickup there, so it leaves them needing a conversion here on third and a tough nine.
So many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blow. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
On third down, Vic. Oh, it's a touchdown if he holds on. Instead, it's fourth down.
That's a good job there creating the contact to force the incompletion. And now, since it's fourth down, that should set up a field goal situation.
And a nice sigh of relief defensively to be able to hold them to three. And Gold is able to put it through. And the lead moves to 10-0. Maybe a little fortunate there. That was leaking a little. Maybe leaking a lot, but he got it.
Yeah, he actually was able to make it work. How about the body language, though, right? As you watch that ball leak to the right, trying to bring it back in. And that just enough to get it done.
Now it's Gold after splitting the uprights to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Now here's the signal caller getting ready to lead this offense again. And he comes out on the heels of an interception he threw last time they...